I will save your mother, says sexiness. I want that boy to get married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. After all, he is the prince I said. He's next line of the throne. I mean, we're not exactly the oldest people in the world. But on the other hand, we're not going to live forever. And I just know I'd feel much better, much easier, and much more relaxed in my mind if I knew that boy was married, settled, and set. That is absolutely verbatim. Exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But that's my cross to paint. And I don't want you to worry your head one tiny bit about the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. He makes me miserable. It makes me suffer. And I just have to put up with it. But I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude toward him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man. But he is your father and I want you to respect him. There's only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your health, your happiness, and your future. And that's what I'm talking about right now. Your future. And I want to make myself absolutely clear. I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership. And I wouldn't want to see my little boy make the same mistake I did and wind up miserable the way I did. You are a prince. You must marry someone suitable. Someone who is good enough and fine enough and smart enough for my nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And she has to be a princess. I mean a real princess. That's one thing I absolutely insist upon. She must be a real, genuine, bona fide princess. Just as I was. Oh, that's what you really want, isn't it? Someone like me. Of course you do. Oh God, if I was only 20 years younger. Dauntless, just remember this. You must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Don't interrupt. Well,
Sir Harry wishes to speak to you, madam.
Well.
Madam, I have the honor to request a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, a princess of royal blood. One who will suit both Your Majesty and Prince Dauntless.
No!
Mama!
No, no, no! We've been through all the eligible girls in all the neighboring kingdoms. There are none left. We simply have to wait till the little sisters grow. That'll take years.
But madam, I plan to head north, over the mountains.
Over the mountains?
Across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands?
And into the swampland where the beautiful swamp lily grows.
Into the marshland! Are you out of your mind?
Let him go, Mama, please!
You won't find anything there but frogs and tadpoles.
Mama!
Do you know what the weather's like?
Mama, please.
Do you know how damp and foggy it is?
Mama.
Quiet! You'll be an oppressive!
Mama, please. For me, Mama, please.
All right, all right.
Me.
Go ahead. Your silence. Come along, Dauntless. We miss your cocoa.
Good luck, Harry. Good luck.
Don't be afraid, little Larkin. I'll become a princess who's not only a true princess, but will pass the queen's test.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
You know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
True princess. And then one sunny morning, just when the crocuses were beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in the north round tower spied two distant figures approaching at full gallop. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry's back! Sir Harry's back with a new princess! Now let's see, how does this park on the old story? On a stormy night, to the castle door, came a lass the prince had been waiting for. That, of course, is utterly untrue. It wasn't storm that night at all. As a matter of fact, it wasn't even night, and the princess had only looked as though she'd come in from a storm.
any princess. I figured the early bird. Anyway, who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
No!
Someone's being bashful,
Say, you new here?
Yes.
Watch closely. This perfect plain piece of parchment. Notice that it has no folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
It's a nut house!
No, wait, no,
wait, don't go!
You're the one, I guess.
Yeah, I'm Prince Dauntless. The drab.
Well, glad to meet you.
But don't go! I like you! Everybody likes you! Well, almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother. So, I guess I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the farms.
But I really like you.
You do? Why?
You swear the moat.
Dauntless, I know I swear the moat, but that's not the real me. I'm not actually like that. Actually, I'm shy!
She's in the mud!
You want to see her swim, Mama? She's wonderful.
Yes, isn't she?
She swam the moat.
It's cold.
Twice. Can I marry her now, Mama? Can I please, Mama?
Marry her? Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a real one.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred.
You're the late. She's been here and gone.
Gone?
Yes, that's a hurry with no princess!
Ah, but she is, Your Majesty.
What?
That one? You jest.
I'm not Miss Nattis. Where she is? I have her papers right here.
Ah, gross.
The Princess Winifred, Princess of Icemkill, Guardian of the Midgard Serpent, and Warden of the Ragnarok Marsh Lily. Look, the inscription on her family crest reads, "To deceive malice, say contra adiantor ito."
What does that mean?
Roughly, it means the person doesn't succeed.
Never mind!
You see, Mama? That means she is a princess. Yeah, Mama! At least give her a test. It's only fair. Please, Mama.
All right. We'll test her. Blizzard and I will put on our thinking caps and make a nice fair test, just as we always do, and prove to you that this girl cannot possibly be a real princess.
Grab her by the leg! This is her leg!
We'll test her for...
That's not my leg!
She'll have a test and she'll fail like all the others. Fair and square!
Fail what?
Royalty test.
Every princess suing for my hand in marriage has to pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
Well, what kind of test?
Well, it's usually always highly secret.
Oh, well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I really need to get out of these wet clothes.
Shall I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
And you're good looking too.
You're better looking.
Nicer too.
But you're a better swimmer.
I know.
Oh, Your Majesty, I'm so excited. Sir Harry is back. Yes, he is. And he's brought us a sweet princess. Have you seen her? Neither have I. But I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom. And I'm to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. Isn't he thoughtful? He arranges everything.
Yep. So my father expected me to follow in his footsteps. Then I landed this jester job. And from then... What's wrong?
Who?
A lady. Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. A bird. Some kind of bird. Hawk. Bluebird. Capper, dove, eagle, finch, grouse, hawk, chevy, key, lark, martin, bark! Bark!
Hey, Larkin.
And... A knight!
Which knight?
Sir Harry! Dust? Sounds like dust. Sounds like the... Lust!
No, must. Must what? You're going to start over, right?
She's in trouble?
What kind of trouble?
Big trouble? How many syllables?
She's going to have a baby.
Well, does anyone else know? Sir Harry.
Of course, but it's an animal besides Sir Harry.
Oh, don't you worry, Your Majesty. We can keep it a secret. The question is, can you?
We know you can't talk. You can't talk, but you can manage to communicate.
Now the bishop declares our behavior is crude, as he piously looks to the sky. 'Cause when we go in swimming, we always go the king and the jester, the king and the minstrel. Oh, the venter makes wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 barrels were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody knows. Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate pre-roll, and the fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastry?
This is a blessing.
Also the curse of being the true elite.
The king has asked to meet the young lady. Why? He's never asked before. He heard she swam the moat.
Dallas, is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is, I really don't.
Oh, no. My father, he's silent.
Oh, well, I'd love to meet him.
Father, this is the Princess Winifred.
Your Highness, the king welcomes you.
Oh. And he asked me to tell you that he hopes you get a 100 on the test tomorrow.
Well, thanks.
My father, he never places his crown to his heart unless he absolutely means it. Alas, madam, the king is mute, or he would speak for himself. He's still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says, King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Well, the mouse devours the hawk. Okay, why can't you just get a big mouse and a little hawk and put them together?
We tried that once. The mouse got scared and ran away, and then the hawk bit Daddy.
Well, you just let me get this test under my belt and we'll figure something out. Don't you worry. Certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty.
Now that is a nice man.
Oh, Your Majesty.
I think you better speak to Prince Thomas about, you know. About what? Your father feels that he's been neglecting his duty. And now that you're old enough, he thinks you're ready to have that little chat. You know,
man to man.
You mean about things? You mean now? Well, the king thinks it might be better to wait until later. Says he has to look up a few things first.
Well, I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
Well, we want you to be happy here. We know it's a lot different from what you're used to.
Well, it is a little hard making the adjustment to dry land and everything.
You must feel like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. See, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. Well, some of the poorer people do, but the nobility all live right in the swamp with their servants and pets.
You have pets?
Lots.
Dogs?
Frogs.
Oh.
I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. The swamps of home are
Thanks. Ladies? Doubtless I have to change now.
You do? Okay.
No, Doubtless, it's bad luck to see too much of a bride before the wedding.
Oh.
Hurry, ladies. May we show you the gowns, now, Your Highness?
Yes.
Now, here's the very latest thing from... They do such lovely work, don't you think? Notice the fullness in the back and the window sleeves cut right down to the... Well, it looks marvelous on, and it's really you. Don't you think, Lady Meryl?
Yes, stunning.
Perhaps Her Highness would like to look in the mirror.
Does Her Highness have a favorite color?
Well, back home we wear a lot of dark green and earth brown, but I guess you could say my favorite color is my own dress there. Huckleberry. Tell you what, leave them all, the ones I can't use, I'll send back. Very good. Ladies?
Think up something to help that what's-her-name asleep.
Flip your skirt, open, close, right, right, wrong! Doesn't anyone here know the Spanish panic?
We do, Your Majesty.
Thank heavens somebody's up to date around here. Why don't we all watch as court dancers their studly Lady Penelope demonstrate?
My lady, is something wrong?
No,
I... Well, we're glad of that, anyway.
I felt faint, that's all. I was sitting in my room sewing, and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out here and get some air.
And I see you were planning to camp out for a while.
Oh, Your Majesty, you don't know! You just don't know! Do you have any idea what can happen in the relationship between a man and a woman? I'm glad I found out when I did. It's better this way. I'm leaving.
You're leaving?
Yes, I'm leaving the service of the Queen forever.
That's a pretty big step to take all alone.
I have no choice.
You're leaving forever?
Yes.
You'll need help.
Who would help me?
I, my lady.
What did you say? You want to take care of Lady Larkin. But who's going to take care of you?
Chivalry demands that we protect a damsel in distress.
If you say so, Your Majesty.
But she'll have to travel light. The way a man does.
Yes. She'll go as a boy. We can steal one of Prince Thomas's suits. Let us get these things out of the way. You can wait in your room.
No, I don't need help from anyone, thank you. I can go alone.
Over the wall?
Yes, I don't need help from anyone.
Oh, you'll be fine once you get past the water rats.
Rats?
Oh, yes. They live right next to the quicksand.
Quicksand?
Beyond the wall which you must climb, it's 22 feet and covered with slime.
Slime?
Infested with spiders.
Spiders?
The spiders are sweet compared to the snakes on the other side.
But don't worry about them. They won't hurt you. Unless you plan to go alone.
Well, I did, but if I would have known it was so terrible out there.
You think I can hold? Second thought and come with me. I know all the
come try those wings. Come swift, for we have things to do.
So you. I like you, friend. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I like you. I mean I love you.
When she shows you all how strong she is, she'll stand right up and cheer.
Let the party be, let the party be, friend, friend.
I'm in love with her.